Welcome back to Let's Play Shadow the Edgehog.
For the truth.
This playthrough is almost done. We've got just one thing left to do.
Alright, it's the boss, right?
It's the boss of this playthrough. Now that we've gone completely 100% evil, what are we gonna do about it?
Well, I think the general guy is just gonna come out and shoot Shadow right in the forehead.
You know, that would have been a lot easier and probably would have made a lot more sense than what he actually does.
I mean, we'll still have Central City. It's an advantage.
Or what's left of it, at least.
Yeah, a couple rocks. That used to be the department store.
Oh, by the way, everyone evacuate now for a robot attack that's going to be happening tomorrow. Anyway, yeah. So now Sonic's against us.
I can't let you go. Not like this.
And he came from where?
No, that was you guys! Gunn did that!
Exactly!
Or he's talking about, like, recently, because that was me.
Oh, yeah, that was totally us. I mean, I'm not going to mince words there.
They don't value life.
So, okay.
Pay with their lives.
Yeah, they don't value life because you killed them!
I need to prepare myself for this one.
If you try to stop me, I'll destroy you.
Is it just like a bad boss fight, or is it that asinine?
Oh, it's an asinine bad boss fight.
Oh, yeah. This is for my family. And for me. Oh, my God.
So here we go.
Oh, melodramatic bullshit.
With Sonic and Diablon. Sonic is going to be bothering us throughout the whole entirety of the mission.
Oh, good.
There are some guns out here, but essentially here's how it's supposed to go. He has a force field on.
No.
And he has a particle cannon as well that does an area of effect damage and hurts like balls.
Yeah, no kidding.
So there's that. And again, Sonic's here is just to bother us. So he only takes down his shield when he's about to attack or punch us. And that usually happens when we homing attack off of Sonic and get up in the air.
Oh, okay.
But because he is mostly shielded half the time, guns don't have much of an effect, and we can't use the same strategy we usually do.
So you're telling me that this is a long and tedious fight.
You got any popcorn?
That's not the whole episode, is it?
Oh. No, it is not the whole episode.
Oh, thank Christ. You scared me there for a second. Like,
No.
Okay, good. Mercy.
We are going to start playthrough number 4 here pretty soon, so don't worry.
It's just when people mention popcorn, I'm in it for the long haul. So I was just making sure I mean...
We're still going to be here a while, though, so...
Well, all right, so I mean... Is there anything else to say about this boss fight, or can we just shoot the shit for a while?
Let's shoot the shit for a while.
Oh my God. That's a good sign.
So, how you been, dude?
Not too bad.
You don't get to talk too much outside of work, so just tell me how you're doing.
Doing pretty good. Breath of the Wild is a game that's still pretty good. Resident Evil 7's really good. This is the year that good games are coming back, man.
No kidding. It's like, you know, these game companies have decided to make the games that they like to make and people like when they make them. Here you go.
Didn't we come up with a theory? I think this was actually your calculations that, like, every 10 years we're going to get a year of good games. Because 2007 was the last year that, like, really good games came out.
1997, that's the year Ocarina of Time came out, you know, all those other landmark 3D games, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Half-Life came out then. You know, 2007, we had another great year of games with Portal and a bunch of others, like Assassin's Creed, that revolutionized open-world games.
That was Mario Galaxy as well.
Mario Galaxy, and then 2017, we're getting all these games. So, yeah, it's a 10-year cycle.
And that's so sad. That we have to wait 10 years for an onslaught of good games instead of, like, multiple years with just a few handfuls of good games every once in a while.
Well, hey, maybe if this industry actually fucking learned something once in a while and look back at their history, maybe they could keep that 10-year thing and have it go on for, I don't know, 5 years.
Now, you know what I'm afraid of? Because we've had plenty of good games. We got Breath of the Wild, Tales of Berseria, It got Resident Evil 7. What I'm worried about is a lot of these companies will take a look at that formula and go, hey, that worked. Let's just do it again. So if we see Resident Evil 8 in like 2 years, I hate to say I told you so.
Well, will they have new ideas? Because maybe they're realizing that it's quality over quantity.
Maybe, and it looks like Capcom is doing DLC a bit better this time, where...
It's not actually on the disc?
Yeah, it's not on the disc. They're taking their time to make it, because as soon as you beat the game, it says, hey, you got free DLC coming later. Enjoy that.
And there's... Well, the first thing that happens is, hey, season pass, check it out.
Well, yeah, that too, and... While I don't like season passes, I still appreciate all the stuff you're getting, because you get a lot of stuff for your money.
It's kind of weird that I've bought season passes for the last two games I've bought. I bought a season pass for Breath of the Wild, and I bought a season pass for Resident Evil 7.
How is that season pass for Breath of the Wild, by the way? Because I didn't get it yet, because it didn't look that appealing.
Right now, you don't get anything. Like,
oh,
you know, but you just get only 3 treasure chests. One that holds a ruby, one that holds some rupees or something, and one that holds a really jarring Nintendo Switch shirt.
A Switch shirt.
Uh-huh.
On your Wii U version, you get a Switch shirt.
Yep.
wishful thinking, I guess.
And it only has one defense, and you can't upgrade it.
What? So it's not even worth it.
It's not even worth it.
See, that's the part I don't like about that season pass, is all they give you is crap until the rest of it's finished.
Well, because Nintendo doesn't know how season passes work quite yet.
They are still catching up a bit. I completely agree with that.
Nintendo is a very traditional Japanese company, and as they say in Japan, it's 10 years behind Canada.
Oh, God. Yeah, that's what I don't get. They're like... Highly
fax
advanced.
Machines are still highly used over there.
Oh, dear Lord. They're...
Well, one of my favorite DJs, Michita Satoshi, he uses like an old 1997 computer for his shit. I mean, he showed a picture of one of his DJ devices. God damn it! One of his DJ devices. It still had an A drive floppy in there.
What?
That's how old school Japan is.
Oh my God. And that's the hilarious thing. Isn't Japan like 10 years ahead of us technology-wise? Like, major breakthroughs in technology?
A lot of retro tech guys out there, too. Especially around Akihabara.
Right, yeah. There's plenty of stores that sell old-fashioned tech. I knew about that, but I always saw them as, like, ahead of the curve when it came to brand new tech, and they're still using floppy disks for certain things?
That's cheaper, I guess. It's like, why would I want to pay $15,000 for this brand new tech when I can just pay $300 for this, you know, still functional computer that gets everything I want to get done?
Hmm. Speaking of technology, you guys don't have to buy a Switch yet.
I did it
for you. Let's just say it could be a lot better. It's not the most technically powerful thing in the world. It actually chugs on TV screen mode. It does better in handheld mode, and you guys don't need to buy a Switch. Sorry if you already did.
Damn it. Ah,
good God!
I was trying to think maybe I could disable his shield by getting rid of all those blue things, but... Well, saw how that goes, so let's try this again.
Alright.
Frustration's setting in. So, back to shooting the shit. I got the Wii U version myself, and it... plays just fine. Yeah, there are some frame rate issues, but there's still other games for the Wii U.
Well, I think the frame rate issues come with open world games, because I know Skyrim did that at certain times. Oblivion, Fallout definitely has some chugging.
Yeah, Bethesda RPGs are infamous for having all those glitches and just being a Bethesda RPG, you know? Mm. Just the quirks that come with it. And for a game as massive as Breath of the Wild to have frame rate problems, you know, I can kind of forgive that.
I can too, just as long as it doesn't mess with me. I think I've only had it happen once where there was actually an entire second of lag, which caused a problem, but other than that, it's been fine.
I had one moment where, just one segment today actually, where it I had like 2-3 second long lags all in a row.
Oh.
In one area, because there were like 10 enemies there were using a huge weapon. I was smacking him in the face really hard. There was fire everywhere. I'm surprised the thing even held up.
Yes.
Did I tell you that Violet softlocked the game?
No, because I recently softlocked the game. How'd you do that?
Well, she was in the desert, about to do the main quest line attached to that. What you gotta do is you gotta run into the palace and talk to the chief, start a cutscene. Mm-hmm. Well, she walked to the palace, up to a throne that was empty because it was late at night, and she was still asleep. So, all hail the chief of Gerudo! slammed the spear she was holding down on the floor. Camera zooms out for a ruler that's not there. It just kind of holds.
Oh, soft locks.
Like, what did you do?
Well, I thought it was actually really bad that my Switch crashed. And we're not talking like it kind of stuttered a bit and then stopped working. No, this was a bad crash. I didn't think I was able to break a system like this. Basically, I went to, for those who are living in the dark, the Switch, it's a handheld game console that you can put into a dock, and then it switches the signal to your TV. And that's fine. But I was done for the night. I was all done playing. I went and detached the Joy-Cons and went to put them on the Switch screen. That way I could turn off the console, because apparently you can't do it just by holding down the button. And pulled out the Switch, and the game froze. No sound, no nothing, it was just gone. And
like
the worst...
pulling out an NES cart?
Yeah. Yeah, it was bad. It didn't ruin the picture or anything, but the bad thing was I could actually hear the Switch chugging. There's like a little fan opening on the top of the console, and I could hear it chug, and I went, oh no, I probably just bricked the thing. And,
what have you done?
Seriously, I thought I broke it, but no, after 2 hours, it finally came back to consciousness. So at that point, I was just like, just let it die. I haven't let the batteries run out of it yet. Probably should do that before it ends up getting completely destroyed.
Yeah, I should mention that my Wii U gamepad has a gigantic crack. It has a huge crack in it, and its display is no screen. That's kind of the reason why I haven't been playing my Wii U a whole lot. And, what's crazy is that it still works.
Yeah, that's what I don't understand. You have some of the most interesting technical anomalies, and yet they still work.
Yeah.
Like a broken gamepad, that should not work.
See, what happened is I was trying to set it up in a place that it would charge, but it became a little top-heavy because the cradle is not exactly the most stable of things to put the Wii U gamepad on, and it fell and it cracked.
Oh.
So, just the touchscreen is... the touchscreen still works fine, too.
There's just no picture.
There's just no picture, but there's still sound. Headphone jack still works. You know, it's got a little issue holding a charge now, probably because it doesn't know what to do when it doesn't have a fucking picture display. But the buttons still work, and you know, I've had my Wii U on longer in the past week than I have all last year.
Yeah, and all it takes is that one good game for you to finally think, hey, maybe this console, I should play it a bit more.
I haven't even turned on my PS4.
And that's hilarious. Oh my god, dude. Oh my god. Oh my, okay. Sorry to interrupt there, but I thought you were just about to run out to your doom. But yeah, that's pretty much going to be me here soon, where all of a sudden the console I've been playing the most is going to go on hold while I play another game for a completely different console, because Persona 5 is almost out, and that's going to take up a lot of my time.
Yeah, I got to play some games. I mean, I've still got several soul-destroying games to play.
Do you consider Neo soul-destroying?
Well, it depends on what you mean by destroying souls. I mean, Dark Souls is a soul-destroying game, but it's a very gratifying experience. Neo is soul-destroying, but it's very gratifying, but it's the fucking inventory system that's got me fucking addicted. Because then I'm focused on the numbers. I gotta get my numbers higher. It's like, ooh, I found this thing. Is it better than the one thing I do have? Well, okay, I'm gonna see if I can combine this thing into the thing I have now, so it's a better thing in the version of the thing I have now, and hopefully a better version of the thing that's there. So, yeah, it's a never-ending cycle.
Holy shit, my numbers are better than the other numbers. I better number it up.
It's like, all right, I got my numbers high. Oh, wait, the numbers up here are too high. Now I can't roll as fast anymore. Oh, well, I guess I... Oh, wait, these numbers are pretty good. I guess I'll go with this number because it lowers this number. But then again, I think I have a higher version of this number that's a lower version of that number. So I'm going to use that number. They just should have called this game numbers.
I could just see you with a giant flow chart and a long list of all the equipment you've had. And you're going like, okay, what won't take down my numbers? Shit, that takes down my numbers. What if I put this other number in here? No, that takes down another number. But this increases two numbers, so there might be an advantage.
Yeah, about the flow chart. Let me just,
Oh, God, have you really? I was just kidding.
No.
Oh, okay. Jeez. Oh, you scared me there.
Oh, boy, I crumple some papers. He flips his shit. Oh, my God.
I can't see you. Now, if you're right in front of me and you started flipping papers, I would be like, oh my god, he actually did.
It's the power of the human ear and the human brain coexisting as one.
Easily manipulated co-host. That's why I brought him along.
I think don't call me Jester for nothing.
By the way, I'm glad you finally finished Okami after 3 years.
Glad I finished this boss too.
Yay! It's gone. Yay! That took forever. Holy God! They expect you to have fun with that?
I'm pretty sure I should have broken those blue things to lower his shield, but Sonic was not making that easy for me.
Is that what you're supposed to do?
I felt like so, but it felt too tedious, and it felt like no, this can't be it. This can't be it. But it was. I think maybe.
That was atrocious.
We're going to have to fight him again when we go into the good all-dark side, I guess.
So does Sonic die this time? Does he put a gun to his forehead and then fires?
Oh, I hope.
Goodbye, Doctor.
So Sonic asks a really dumb question here.
What are you going to do? Are those the Chaos Emeralds?
He's got all the Chaos Emeralds, yada, yada, yada. And then...
Shadow...
Do you love me?
What are you going to do with them?
And he just drops his arms like, what do you think I'm going to do with them? I'm going to redecorate my house.
I'm Shadow, the Hedgehog.
The Edgehog, excuse me.
Order and justice to the humans. With the power of these emeralds, I'm going to destroy...
Tell me, is this who you are?
This is who I am.
Okay, thanks for clarifying.
Wait a minute. I'm going to save the humans. I need to protect the justice of the humans. So I'm going to blow them all up.
Lawful evil. All right, Power Man 5000.
I think that's more like blatant stupidity. That's like the horror movie villain who kills to save people.
I got to get this soundtrack. It's so good. Hey, Samurai Blade. Finally, an actually useful weapon.
All of that for that?
Well, yeah. So now that was called Punishment, Thy Name is Ruin, ending 001, as in it's the first ending you'll probably get. So, all right, to the next one, number 4. Do-do-do-do-do, charge.
So is there anything special going on with this one? What is our goal here?
All right, our goal here, it's going to be the almost hero route. You saw we got the neutral route, we got the all hero route, and we got the all dark route. But there's two routes that are in between the neutral and the respective hero and dark routes.
Mm-hmm.
So, we're going to go almost hero. We're going to do like a couple of good things, mostly a couple of neutral things, and well, actually a lot of it's going to be neutral. But hey, neutrals are usually the best ones to go with anyway.
So I'm just trying to imagine this in my head. We do a bunch of good things, and then all of a sudden we do like one neutral, maybe one bad thing, and that'll get us the ending. Or is it more complicated?
I'm gonna tell you one thing. We're gonna do neutral right now.
Oh, so just beat the level.
We're just zipping to the end here.
That'll
hit,
work.
And up, Black Doom's gonna show his face.
I'm just thinking, how does Black Doom or Doom Eye give a high five? Does he just splat himself onto your hand? That'd be kind of gross.
Oh, I'd like to hear Black Doom ordering a high five.
Shadow up high.
Oh, God. That's disgusting. Oh, I got his eye juices all in my hand. Oh, it's a good thing all of our characters wear gloves.
I might want to wash my hands.
My damn hands. Gonna destroy this damn planet. I mean, it's no goodbye doctor, but it'll do in a pinch, I guess.
Goodbye, damn doctor. So you just put damn anywhere, and all of a sudden it's Shadow the Hedgehog dialogue.
My damn switch crashed. Oh, Shadow.
Gotta use... I failed the damn triangle jump.
Oh.
But I don't care about the damn frame rate of Breath of the Wild.
Shadow, please.
I don't care about the damn weapon degradation system. I call it a challenge. A damn challenge.
Shadow, please.
Okay, we're gonna get that damn key for once? I mean, we're gonna get... Nah, fuck it.
Screw the keys. Keys are for later. Keys are for when we're actually having fun, right?
Not now.
Well, right. I mean, it'll probably be in playthrough number 75 or how many there are.
We only gotta play it 10 times. Well, okay, 10 times, but still.
Yeah, that's 10. That's 1-0. That's double digits, man.
Most people just play it once, get the credits, and that's it. As I understand, that's what the Game Grumps did.
Yeah, I think... by the way, if you haven't watched that series, it's fucking hysterical.
I think it's been a while since I've seen it, but yeah, they only played it once, and that was it. No, but nope, we gotta get the true ending.
Oh, do you have to get all 10 endings to get the true ending?
Yeah, that's why we're doing this.
What a bunch of shit. Okay, fine, I'm now in it. I gotta see this true ending crap.
A true ending that retcons all the endings before it.
Wow!
It's like, you know, there's 10 endings, but then there's, like, you know, the 11th ending that goes on beyond one of those endings. So which ending is it? Well, I don't know. Let's figure it out together. Fucking ladies. A rank.
Oh, good job.
Perfect.
I would love it if when you go to get that 11th ending, you still had to play this first stage and then it just jumps you to the last ending.
That's not the case.
Just like, we're not going to have you do this. It's just going to hook you straight to the end.
So, alright, play those cutscenes again. We're back to the desert. The glyphic ruins, I think they're called. But first we gotta have Black Doom get angry at Shadow for not listening to him and killing cops and just getting the second Chaos Emerald.
You didn't give me 5.
I mean, kill the cops? Kill the aliens? Oh man, left wing, right wing much? I'm gonna go central on this, certainly.
Kill the animals.
Yeah.
Doing a speed run, right? Kill the animals.
So, Glyphic Canyon. We're going to be doing the good part this time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I woke up in Vegas, blacked out. What did I do?
So here we go. Finally something new. 23 minutes into this episode, and we're going to get to something interesting.
Oh my gosh, look at this. I recognize this place. This is where we talked about how crap Sonic Chronicles is, I believe.
Yep, and here's Knuckles, the guy who got kidnapped in that opening act.
He did?
He got kidnapped. Knuckles got kidnapped.
Smooth move, Knucklehead.
Because the game is all based around, like, a dark version of the tribe that Knuckles is a part of that guards
what?
The Angel Island, and...
They go,
they go into space, it becomes Mass Effect for a while, I swear I think I saw a Krogan. And Eggman becomes a good guy, and then he becomes a bad guy at the end, and then there's a cliffhanger, and then the credits are done through dialogue!
Wait a minute! How did I miss this part? Is this just something you're supposed to know, or...?
What part?
No, the thing you just explained, or did I just not pay attention enough?
Oh, the cliffhanger ending?
Yeah.
I never mentioned it?
No, you didn't.
Oh, yeah, no. So, okay, here's how the game goes, because I'm going to spoil it, because fuck it, it's about 9 years old.
Right now. Okay.
So, they all go out into space or something, you know, but they need a way to get out to space. The way to do that is to help with Eggman, and Eggman is getting harassed by these weird aliens, too. So, he helps for a little... He becomes a party member for a while, but...
what?
But, so then, with the help of Eggman... He sends you out to space and all that. So while you're out in space, doing this stuff, saving the world and all that, or whatever, and then you beat the final boss, save the world, got the Chaos Emerald, and everything's all good and fine, and then you come back, only to find that Eggman has practically taken over the world in your absence.
And
that's where the game ends.
The... Oh my god.
It's like that happens, and then Sonic and Tails pop up and say, "Wow, that seems exciting. I have to wait until the next part of the go. Anyway, who developed this game, Tails?" Well,
do they really do that?
It's fucking bad, man.
God.
I can't see how people can say, "Oh, that's yeah, it's a great game." That's the kind of delusional Sonic fanboy I don't want to be, you know.
Like, so basically,
delusion that's saying that this game isn't that bad, even though I'm ripping my hair out because of it. But Sonic Chronicles fucking insults me. It's an insult that BioWare can make something so crap. It's the worst thing they've made since Mass Effect 3.
Wow.
Or Dragon Age 2, or what? Whatever everyone's favorite whipping boy is for BioWare these days.
I don't know. It might be Mass Effect Andromeda, because have you seen those animations? They look awful!
They're the same animations they've had for years!
Exactly, they're all stiff and everything! Commander Shepard, more like Commander Cardboard. I don't know. They just look terrible.
They have the same drinking animation where they hunch over the bar, they take the shot, then they hit it, and then they... You know what I'm talking about, right?
Oh, yeah, I know it.
It's like Snow White and Seven Dwarfs. You go...
Oh, my God, I haven't seen that movie in years. That was a blast from the past. Thank you.
How the fuck did that pop in my head? Jesus Christ.
Wow, you have reached back in your mind for that small scene.
See, Sonic kind of makes you regress back into your childhood.
Yes, it does. Oh, God. You know what? I think I'll enjoy Andromeda if they have a scene like messing with the reporter in Mass Effect 2.
It's the same one.
Yeah, yes! If they do the exact same one, if I have a chance to say I've had enough of your disingenuous assertions and then punch a woman in the face, that would be hysterical!
That's the classiest thing to say to someone before you punch them in the face! It's like, "Hey, I've had enough of your bullshit, motherfucker!"
No, not enough class. It has to be disingenuous assertions.
I grow weary of your disingenuous assertions. Disingenuous assertions! It even rolls off the tongue so well!
It's such a good line! And yet, ironically, it's one of the worst lines I've ever heard.
It's one of the best lines! What are you talking about? For what you do to someone and, like... you don't even expect it, either. I mean,
exactly!
It's just, the reporter pops up. Start saying some things, and then I guess I just hit the...
Let's see. This doesn't sound so bad.
To me, it's like, I didn't expect the running action to be, you know, great, but I figured that, you know, like, all right, I guess I'll end it here. No, don't punch her!
That's the one thing that kind of aggravates me about games like Mass Effect, is the choice I pick is nothing like what I thought. It's like I'm saying, hello, would you like a glass of tea? What'd you say about my alien mother? Ah, shit. Now I gotta fight this guy.
That's better in Dragon Age Inquisition, I think, or I can just talk great about that game forever.
Yeah, I think Dragon Age did it a lot better than Mass Effect did.
Yeah. I had a lot more fun with Dragon Age Inquisition than I did with Mass Effect 2, and I had a lot of fun with Mass Effect 2.
Right, I was also a fan of Mass Effect, but it kind of lost me. Partial ways into. Maybe it's just because I was reeling for the fact that I punched a reporter in the fucking face. That was hilarious.
Making a bisexual elf is a dream come true, though, so hey.
Oh, well, at least we have options.
Bisexual lady elf that I control, and... Yeah, I guess I'll warp, but I have a feeling this is going to just bypass all these enemies.
Yep, there they go.
I feel like that's exactly what I did.
Yeah, you did. What do we have? Three enemies left?
There's no save point. That's 60, I think.
Oh, wait, 60 or 50? I can't read that.
That's 60, but now we're on 54, 50. I think we're good.
Unless there's just that one, which, you know, is par for the course for the series so far. I mean,
and where'd he?
Oh, there we go.
That's it.
Hey, wait a minute. Those are the same enemies from Sonic 06. Are they seriously reusing assets from Shadow the Hedgehog?
Reusing assets, or are they just using it in addition to that?
Okay, you got me.
Like, I imagine that Sonic 06 and Shadow the Hedgehog are being co-developed at the same time at this point.
Yeah, I think you're actually right. If we go by development time and the fact that they rushed Sonic 06. Oh, maybe.
Is there no way back?
One left. Of course.
One left. I can't find the save points to find my way back. Oh, wait, there it is.
Yep, there it is. Don't scare me like that, dude.
I got a little terrified, so...
All right. I could tell with your panic play.
So let's go back and see if we can't find that one alien.
The one guy. Do you think this guy feels relieved that he escaped Shadow the Hedgehog's, like, death rays and everything?
Oh, there he is.
Oh, wait.
Wait a minute! There's still more black aliens! There's more than 60 aliens in this level!
Good God.
Why isn't every level like that?
Oh, good job, Knucklehead. You found a good level.
Well, cool, I guess.
Sure.
You know, I'll end on a somehow positive. You know, B, it's, you know, I'll take that. So, if you have us, we'll see you next time on Let's Play Shadow the Edgehog. Maybe we got whole new levels. Maybe it'll get better. Who knows?
Hopefully. Well, unless Rue shows up and then it's just downhill from there.
Well, I'm pretty sure that if the rest of the game is to be believed, it's just going to be downhill from regardless. So, hey, we'll see you next time!